Hey Shelly, we'll take a look at these Sandia Mountains. All that haze you see back there is pretty bad for your health. You might even find yourself coughing because of the smoke particles that come from those fires. And on top of the wildfires that we're seeing, we're also seeing high methane levels, and much of our state is in a drought.
I think we're in a crisis mode, and I think we're trying to look at so many different crises, we don't know which one to kind of focus on the most.
Scientists and climate advocates say New Mexico's air quality is deteriorating.
And we have become a major producer of methane.
Catastrophic events like wildfires, warmer temperatures, and less water. And not just New Mexico, but around the country.
So we're more prone to the fires that you see.
Barbara Weber with Health Action New Mexico says the fires we're seeing right now are different.
So when you have the fires, then obviously it's not just people like me having throat issues. It can seriously affect you if you already have some underlying respiratory issues. But it's also people having to leave their homes.
And if we don't start taking action, Weber says we'll likely see another public health crisis in the next decade if something doesn't change.
This is real. This is happening. This is about the quality of life for ourselves, but for the generations to come.
Advocates like Barbara say that they're working on legislation to help address some of these issues. In 2019, the governor did sign an executive order addressing climate change and energy waste prevention. Reporting live in Albuquerque, Maris Armas, KOAT Action 7 News.
Recent report by the American Lung Association gave Eddy, Lee, and San Juan counties failing grades for ozone pollution and high ozone days.